Grayson's a Florida Democrat. He's from Orlando. Congressman, thank you for joining us. You're smiling. Maybe that's hopeful. Do you think there's a winning, is this the winning pill here, basically, to use a healthcare expression, having this this set of plans, the federal employee plan, buy into Medicare at 55 and a trigger if it doesn't work?
These are all good ideas. The important thing is that these will save lives and they'll save money. And those are good things. I'd still like to see a robust public option because it costs billions and billions of dollars to set up a provider network around the country. It's the hardest thing when you're setting up a health care plan. And we're wasting our Medicare provider network by making it available only to 1 out of 8 people. If the 55 and over bill passes, then it'll be 1 out of 5 people, but still 4 out of 5 people will not be eligible. And it's a waste. It's like saying that only people 65 and over can drive on the interstate highways. It just doesn't make any sense. It's a public resource, the Medicare provider network. It should be used by everyone.
So you want Medicare for everybody?
No, what I want is the Medicare provider network available for everybody. If we had Medicare for everybody, I'd be fine with that. What I really want above all is health care for everybody.
Okay. Well, let me ask you about the word progressive. Are you a progressive?
Yes.
Okay, progressive means getting there one step at a time, doesn't it?
Well, we're making progress. That's true.
A radical is somebody who wants everything the way they want it now. That's what a radical
right.
is.
Right. But what I don't understand
is somebody that moves along step by step so that everybody can get aboard, so that we have a democratic process that gets aboard this new change that we're getting into. But that's the thought. I'm not your teacher. I'm a student. Here's President Obama today. Let's listen.
The Senate made critical progress last night with a creative new framework that I believe will help pave the way for final passage and a historic achievement on behalf of the American people. I support this effort, especially since it's aimed at increasing choice and competition and lowering cost.
So in or out, Brother Grayson? If you had to vote right now.
I'm definitely in, and I think that the president is right. The bill that we're about to vote on is not terribly different from the bill that the president asked for when he was campaigning, and essentially the bill that the American people voted on when they voted for him as president, for the Democrats, for the House, and for the Senate.
Well, now that we've gotten the business over, but let's have some fun. Have you been watching Dick Cheney lately? He was on Fox last night, and it's like he's a homing pigeon when it comes to going to Fox, I suppose. He was on last night accusing the President of the United States of giving aid and comfort to the enemy. I mean, that was the words he used by having a trial in New York for a KSM. And I was thinking, why did he choose constitutional language that defines treason? And then he went further and dug his hole even deeper, burying Barack Obama, I should say, even deeper, by saying the guy doesn't believe in America, basically. He doesn't believe in American exceptionalism, doesn't really love this country. How far is this guy going to go so he gets to speak at the next Republican convention? Dick Cheney is unbelievable lately. Just a thought.
I don't know. You know, on the internet, there's an acronym that's used to apply to situations like this. It's STFU. I don't think I can say that on the air, but I think you know what that means.
Well, give me the first part.
Shut.
Oh, I got you. Yeah, stop talking in crude language. Well, I don't think you're going to get them to do that. Let me ask you this about the first year of the Barack administration. Do you believe we're going to get back home for the holidays, for Christmas and Hanukkah and the rest? Are we going to have a season where something's going to have gotten done in this Congress? Will we have a health care bill on the road to signature by a couple days before Christmas?
The answer is yes, but before we leave the subject, let's talk about the fact that the right wing's been ranting about the fact that the president showed respect for the Emperor of Japan. I can't believe this is happening. You know, I remember when, first of all, President Bush Sr. Did something really awful to the Prime Minister of Japan at a state dinner, and I don't remember those kind of complaints. And then I remember that
he barfed, okay? You don't do that on purpose or on command, sir.
Well, what about Bush Jr.? What about Bush Jr.? I remember Bush Jr. kissing Prince Abdullah on the cheek and then holding his hand for an extended period of time. Maybe if you let him get to second base, then gasoline would be $1 a gallon.
You are unbelievable. All we did was play see the Joe Stafford sign. We played See the Pyramids along the Nile while they're walking along there. We never said they were kissing. Let me ask you this. Do you think the president or the vice president is wise in saying there's a connection between bowing to the Emperor of Japan, which I didn't think was a great idea at all, and the fact that we might get hit again by a terrorist? He has drawn this connection. I find it elusive. Your thoughts?
It's just too bad that it's too late to impeach him. That's all I can say.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Alan Grayson, running for re-election in the Orlando Congressional District of Florida. Up next, two musical icons, Springsteen.